And I'm going to ask our MCs to come forward and get the show rolling. Let's give a big applause for our MCs.
Hello, everyone. Today, we want to welcome you to our theatrical musical presentation of The Star at the Manger.
But who is the star that is in the play that we are going to see?
The star's name is Jesus. The play is about the birth of Jesus. Around the world, people celebrate the birth of Jesus, or now called Christmas. Yes, my friends, I can read from the Bible the verses that talks about Jesus' birth. This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law, and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet.
So let's go and find out from the play who else were there when Jesus was born. Everyone, please join us by singing along with us in celebrating the good news of Jesus' birth. Have fun and enjoy.
Thank you. that was born in Bethlehem. It was the greatest story that was ever told.
What happened when the star was born that day. They cannot tell you the story of Christmas.
But guess what? Today, we brought you some of those who were there to tell you the story.
Yes, I know. I am a chicken. And I was there during the first Christmas.
Yeah, I was there too. What's your memory of that Christmas, Clara?
Oh, it's amusing.
Bah, you are so funny, Clara. We all know why the chicken crossed the road, but why didn't the donkey cross the road? Because he saw what happened to the zebra.
Hey guys, I wasn't there at the first Christmas.
Don't worry, mi amigo. I will tell you what happened. It seems there were two people traveling to Bethlehem that day. Oh, little town of Bethlehem.
How busy I am. I should have never bought this in. Work. Now we're overbooked. Oh. I need help. I have to put an ad in the paper to get some people to help me here. We're too busy. Busy season. Oh. Unbelievable.
Those people to the manger.
Hey, you! I was the reason.
Bonjour, hi. Welcome to Holy Hollywood Inn. How can I help you?
We are looking for a place to stay tonight.
I'm sorry. Our inn is fully booked. Plus, you have to be double vaccinated with a booster shot. The only place I can think of is I could give you the keys to my barn, and you could stay with the animals. Would that work?
Anything, please.
Let me see what I get. I can't find my keys. I apologize. I'm so busy, I can't find my keys. Where are my keys? Where are my keys?
Next one.
Where are we going to stay? I can't wait any longer. Is it possible to stay here tonight?
That's when I noticed something shiny on the other side of the road. It was the key. I crossed the road and got the key. Now I guess you know why the chicken crossed the road.
Talking about Mary and Joseph and their sacrifice to be in the manger, Christmas is all about giving.
Sleeping child.
mean. The baby was born in a manger.
That's amazing!
Yeah, amazing that someone would ever believe such a story. Everyone knows that I am the reason that the baby was born in that manger. You see, it was cold that night when Mary and Joseph arrived.
It's warm. It's a miracle.
That's when I came along and kept Mary and Joseph warm. Now you are all wondering how to thank me. Now you see, it was because of me that the baby was born in that manger. Now, you are all wondering how to thank me.
Oh, please! I was the reason for the baby to be born in the manger!
No, it was me! I was carrying them!
Shame on you guys. Everyone is trying to take credit. Each one of you were important in making Christmas happen. And also in welcoming the baby.
Sorry. I guess we were all just acting a little bit selfish. We were all trying to take the credit.
I got carried away too.
I was there. I brought the wise men from far, bringing gifts to see the baby. So you see, I was the most important in making Christmas happen.
What?
Oh, knock it off, guys. I was just checking to see how you react. The spirit of Christmas is this. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whosoever believes in him will not perish, but have everlasting life.
Amen.
Just as Jesus came. And whosoever believes in him. So you go now and help someone in need.
Well, I can give my eggs to the men's fellowship at Dorian Evangelical Church.
Well, I can join the worship team. I can sing.
Guys, you're only making a contribution, but I am totally committed to give myself. After all, I am the Passover lamb. Think of me next time you order lamb chops.
Oh, come, holy faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come.
How many of you enjoyed it? So, a different perspective of the whole Christmas story from the view of the animals. I saw the chicken and the donkey fighting, and the lamb. I think he became lamb chops at the end. And that was funny. That was funny. That was very good. And ultimately, what were they trying to say? I think the camel had a message, and the camel tried to take the credit, but he couldn't. But ultimately, the camel had a message that it's all about Jesus and his birth. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Amen? So it all came down to that. And great job, you guys. You all practiced. In the short time, in the COVID time and all these things, they came and practiced and did a great job. And I just think it was amazing. One thing I should say, as I was sitting there in the back, I thought, so many talented people. You know, I cannot make costumes like these. I cannot dance like that. And I cannot sing like that for sure. So great job, great job. Let's give them one more time.
The director.
Doris, the director, how about you come here?
Doris. Doris, Doris, Doris.
I really thank God for this that we were able to do. I'm not a professional director or anyone, but God's grace, He gave me the anointing and the inspiration. Woo! So with that, I did it. And I really want to, bottom of my heart, I want to thank the people who worked alongside with me. I want to say, Gary, who came from another church, but he dedicated his time for us. Woo-hoo! Josh, let's give Gary and Lynn and the team together. Lynn and the whole team with her. Let's all give a big clap for them. They gave big time. And the musicians, everyone. And the main man in the back, Josh, let's all give a big clap. He's been working hard. And all the actors and everyone who danced, who came up here, Mary, Joseph, let's all give a big clap for them. And all the plays happening, you know what? Look at them, how beautiful they are looking, everyone. How many of you can see how beautiful they are? Woo-hoo. The gowns and everything. Let's give a big clap for Heather. Heather did it all, the gowns and everything. Heather, thank you so much. And Joanne, thank you so much for you guys both. Worked hard to put this outfit for them. Thank you so much. So a lot of work went behind this. And thank you, Jesus, for we were able to do this. And guess what? From tomorrow, there's a new rule, but we get to enjoy today. Yes. So I thank God for that. And be blessed. And Merry Christmas to everyone. In the coming days, God will use us mightily, and all the talents, everyone that you use, you have more. In the future, we will be doing more and to glorify God. Amen. Be blessed.
So were there any bloopers? Were there any mistakes? There was some, okay. I felt some sections were missing. Hey, but this is our first time. This is our first go, right? And what? With 2 weeks practice. 2 much fun, okay. All right, you guys can go.